Toss Now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Washington. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. Morton fields it at the 13. Fleming's the guy that just his freakish ability, you look at him and you go, I can't believe he can do that kind of thing.
Absolutely. I mean, he's a guy that you're looking to isolate against the defense. Try to find the one-on-one matchup. You know, the defense today will do everything that they can to try to have two defenders on him the entire game. But eventually, they're going to make a mistake. And when they leave him alone, look out. That's when this offense will look to make their big plays. Remember, this is college football. All you need is 1 foot down to be able to make this catch. This time, the wide receiver is just too close to the boundary, not allowing himself to get either his left or right foot down.
And off, and he's met immediately. So they end up with a loss after calling the draw.
He started out rushing the passer and then just got lucky and ran right into the running back on the
draw. From their own 28-yard line, third down. He can't get away from the pressure. That makes it fourth and long. Rust is the punter. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. What a hit. The ball changes hands on the punt. Nice opening stand by the defense.
Boy, the crowd was loud and did their part. Now if they're able to move the ball downfield, they can take control of this game early.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And he's tackled at the 46.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
It's second down and 8. Ball on their own 46. Watch out here, and he's taken down
right around the 44-yard line.
Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
But they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He makes it to the 42-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Second and 7. Ball on the 42-yard line.
Downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
We've got a 1st and 10, ball on the 24.
Credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
And he tacks on the extra point. So a 6-play, 57-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Morton takes it to 12. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
Dirk, you got to love the way this football game has started for this team. They put a lot of work into it, and it's working for them.
They've been able to capture the momentum of this game early. It's such a pivotal part of winning a college football game is holding on to that. Now, let's just see if they're able to maintain it.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
They'll work the left side. Nice run to the outside.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to
That makes it second and six.
Second down and six.
Ball on their own 30. Tackle at the 42. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
He's taken down at the 43. Thomas gains about a yard on the play. That brings us second.
Second down and nine to go.
Ball on the 43-yard line. Carries it again, and he's tackled in the backfield. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Quick strike to the receiver. That's a great tackle at the 36-yard line. First down. From the 36-yard line, it's first down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That brings him second and five.
Set up a screen for the wide receivers.
As long as they're making completions and positive yards when they go to the air, then it can't be too bad of a play.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
Boys, you'd love to see from your quarterback because it's contagious. The defense sent all of their linebackers on a blitz, and no one on the offense looked fazed. They came away with big yards and a first down.
Somebody jumped early down there.
False start. Offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. Scrambling around. He's tackled right around the 24-yard line. 4 yards there on the scramble.
That'll bring up second and
10th play of the drive. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's out of bounds around the 17-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 7-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Touchdown.
Let's go.
And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, It's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. An 11-play, 78-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
We get a tie game at 7-7. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Around the 41-yard line. Not much there for the halfback, but he picked up some tough yardage.
Well, nothing fancy here. The back did a nice job of putting his head down and getting the first down.
They'll bring him down right around the 42-yard line.
Number 32 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver. He's hit and taken down. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
Loss of one. That'll bring up second and 11.
Puts it right in his hands. Touchdown. What a display of pure speed.
You know, anytime this guy touches a ball, he has the ability to go the entire length of the field with that speed.
And he hits the PAT. It was a 6-play, 70-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 14-7. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. And they make the stop around the 25-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Pressure and run down.
That brings up third and 14.
And they'll probably try to throw here as they line up on third down and 14. Quick pass. He's out to the 30.
Realized.
Yeah, the defense did a great job of winning that series.
The defense decided to go conservative, sitting back in cover three. They wanted to make sure the receiver was not going to get open past the first down line on that play.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick.
He really got a hold of that one.
He fields a punt at the 20.
They'll bring him down at the 35-yard line.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tackled after a decent pickup. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Here's the run right. He's got nowhere to go.
Call a loss of 1 yard on the play.
Third down. It and he's tackled short. The defense was all over that draw play.
And they got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
Washington will be the return man. And this one is a beauty. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Down at the 40.
If you're going to put the ball into that kind of coverage, you better be accurate, or you'll be wearing a baseball cap and headphones on the sideline standing next to the coach.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 40. Wants it all, going long. And he hauls it in. And he scores. Touchdown. Kirk, that was a beautiful pass and a nice catch.
Well, this is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
You've always got to be on your toes when you're covering this guy. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Slings it, and he's tackled at the 27-yard line. And he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 27-yard line. Lost the ball. Fumble. Tackled for a loss.
It's a good job of securing the fumble and avoiding a turnover.
The Longhorns use their second timeout. He's knocked out of bounds, right around the 34.
That'll bring up fourth and one.
Washington, back to return it. Oh, excellent punt. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. Very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. Here's the screen to the wideout. He's brought down in the open field.
That brings up second and 9.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. Tackle made at about the 37-yard line.
First down.
Pulls it in, but he can't stay in bounds, and that'll be a loss. From the 38-yard line, second down. Makes the first down catch, and he's taken down at about the 21. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Now he's scrambling, runs with it, and he's got room. It's away from him. Touchdown. The extra point. Newberry has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Taken down at about the 27-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
I'm sure both defensive coordinators will be going back to the drawing board in the locker room at halftime. The Longhorns lead 21-14.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This game's been everything we anticipated it being, each team matching each other blow for blow, just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two games match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is. And it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation. They can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, like a good game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later. We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. They're stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Steps out of bounds
around the 27-yard line.
That makes it
second and eight.
Ball on the 27.
Big push there to get in the backfield and bring him down.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
Passes to the wide out and he can't pull it in.
Boy, that hurts the offense to have to go three and out. They're going to have to think about how to get something going the next time they come out.
Washington is back deep to return. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He's to the 40. Tackle at the 43-yard line.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Second and five.
It's second down, five to go.
Ball on the 48.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
Offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive lineman. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Rust to punt. They get this one off and it's a beauty.
He fields the punt at the 13. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. And he's tackled in the open field.
That's a team of one on the play. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 16-yard line, it's second down.
And he throws it away.
But I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football, check it down, or take off and run with it. Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
That makes it fourth and eight.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. Brought down at the 45.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
Makes it to the 41.
Makes the catch ball. That's a gain of 14 yards on that play.
First and 10. Ball on the 41. He's at the 30.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
Cover tight, cover tight. Cover tight.
20. They'll bring him down
around the 15-yard line. We've got a first and 10.
Ball on the 15. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
And that was the sophomore linebacker there who was able to get in and make that tackle.
Gets it. He's in space. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. Newberry has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And down he goes at the 28. Second and seven. Ball on the 28. Scoops it out. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Good hustle there by the D lineman.
It's often an overused term when referring to defensive linemen, but that's what they mean when they talk about a guy has a motor that's running. He never quit, and he played to the whistle.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Positive yardage.
That's a deep. That brings him second and five.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 18. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Thomas gets about 4 yards on the play. His way out to about the six.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. They'll work the left. They bring him down in the backfield.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
Third down and goal to go. Ball on the 1 yard line. And they're in. Touchdown.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for, an opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Three down and one to go. The Longhorns with a 3-touchdown advantage. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Longhorns have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it's set up their offense to be able to score points.
The offense comes out of the field, and they're hoping to avoid the similar fate that killed their last drive.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
They lose four there.
Well, that play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. A great tackle at the 30. Third down. From their own 30-yard line, third down. Complete and taken down immediately.
Number 24 makes the tackle at the 35-yard line.
Double tight, fourth down. Watch 32, watch 32.
Nice run, and he's brought down. It's first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Quick pass. Tackle at the 46. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He's tackled at the 48-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up fourth and one.
Watch the slant. Mike four.
Defense stacked in tight here.
Play 87. Get
up. Quick throw, and they make the stop at the 35-yard line.
This is the second time on this drive alone that the defense has stopped them on first, second, and third down, only to give it up on the fourth down.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and six.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Four down. Mike four.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. He steps out at the 29. Drill at the 35.
Loss of 6 on the play. That'll bring up 4th and 9.
Fourth down again, and let's see if the third time's the charm as they try and put an end to this drive. Goes out of bounds around the 28-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Makes it to the 37.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings in second and 9.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker.
Runs
left and can't get back to the line of scrimmage.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he's stopped before he even gets going.
Fumbles a football. The defense scoops it. Lost the ball. Fumble. Using those good hands, he scoops up the fumble. Out of bounds at the 22-yard line. First and 10. Ball on their own 22. Under a minute left in the game. Brought down at the 20. They'll get him for a loss. This one's in the books, and our final score, the Longhorns, 35, the Grizzlies, 14. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.